Day one
was good. We didn't have any problems. We picked up our stuff at Horsepower Ranch, wide open shop, and got on the road, got to San Felipe. We were able to meet up some friends, have a little dinner, and enjoy the evening. Got up early and watched some sunrise and hit the road this morning.
Where are we headed?
We're headed to Loretto actually tonight. So we'll get another good sunrise in the morning and be off to probably nowhere because there's flooding in La Paz. So we'll probably stay there two nights.
Day three here in Baja. We drove into a Category 2 hurricane yesterday. We survived the night in this miserable hotel in Loretto. Ron here showed me around. We went to some American bar, stopped at a car show. Mike and the guys are in Nevada. They were doing great at the race. I think they broke a controlling arm and messed their hub up or something. They ended up getting it welded back together and finishing. Mike drove overnight to LAX. I think he's probably at LAX right now. He's gonna get on a plane, fly here to Loretto, and I believe we're probably gonna start our 1,000-mile trip back to Ensenada from here, not go to La Paz because it's a nightmare down there. We'll keep you guys posted as it goes on, but so far so good, knock on wood.
Hey, well first, thanks for picking me up, Kurt. We got big Ron the Wolf.
Right here.
Bam, dude. We're in kind of the La Paz.
Loretto.
Yeah.
You haven't had much sleep.
I haven't slept. You got room in your backpack?
Or no. Just an update. How's it going in the car?
It's good. I know, Roger. We're doing good. I mean, listen, we're riding with this guy, Roger Norman. He sleeps and goes fast.
So it's almost noon.
We should have been like mile 150 by now.
Yeah, if we weren't working on radios, we would have been back.
Yeah, we had.
That's how it goes, though, right?
Well, they put a fuel cell in and they had to rip everything out, so a couple little things got missed, but that's all right.
Yeah, that's the way it goes.
Yeah, but sure. We're in Baja, man. Can't be better than this. And, you know, I mean, I just want to be in shape like this guy. Like,
right.
Look at the difference. Look at this. Like, I'm almost like man envy a little bit.
We'll just,
you know, like, I just think really, goals.
It's all about being in Baja. Yeah. That's how it works.
Baby, hear that? I have to be in Baja.
You get a lot stronger. So check it out. We have an extra axle and everything on that thing.
Yeah. Yeah, we have our trailer that he makes too. He makes with extra spindles. Like, it comes with all kinds of stuff. Right.
Mention how they have the tires right there.
Yeah. Sweet. All right, man.
Perfect.
Day one.
right, man. So just give us a recap. How'd the morning start, you know?
It's good, man. We were actually doing this. We were actually cruising.
GoProception?
Yeah, we were actually cruising. You can believe it. We actually were driving. And then standard Michael Scafuto driving broke the transmission.
Well, go back. We had a mishap before that, right?
Yeah, my navigator kept getting us lost.
Okay, yeah. But you decided to hit every big rock you saw, and what happened?
That's true. We have one flat. we have one flat. And granted, those tires came. They should have been changed, Zach. Just saying, those things should have. They should have gotten changed. But in all honesty, we had no idea what we were doing and who we were going with. We knew who we were going with, but we didn't. We thought it was going to be more of a barbecue, hang out, fish tacos, and tequila at night. But it's more like a. It's like a race, you know. We're hitting mile markers like it's
410, right?
Oh yeah, 400. You're right, 400. Yeah, so it's 100 miles. We made it the whole 100 miles in Baja, and our transmission took a shite.
Yeah.
The all the high gear in the rear tranny died, and. Never lift. Yeah. And I gave that one tooth an opportunity to break. I did.
And it grenaded into like 10 pieces, probably.
Yeah.
It was loud.
Day three. Yeah, our sad razor is going home with Kurt and Ron today. True though, I'm in Baja, and all I think about all day long is my wife and kids. I love. Thank you, babe, for always being so rad and supportive for all the things we like to do. Mrs. Norman, thanks for letting me borrow from your husband. Or actually, he borrowed me, so technically,
yep.
I'll send you my bill. And that is just rad all the time.